अस्सलामु अलैकुम। टुडे इज़ आवर ऑनलाइन लेक्चर 11th। एंड टुडे इज़ आवर लेक्चर इज रिलेटेड टू प्रोजेक्ट रिस्क मैनेजमेंट। सो व्हाट इज रिस्क? फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वांट टू टेल यू दैट इन टुडेज लेक्चर, in this presentation only the outline will be given. Whatever I will explain you, it is from chapter 11 from our book, the book I recommend to you. And after listening this lecture, you have to go to your book and read it from there also, chapter 11. So let's start. So what is actually risk? I told you last time, I told you that quality management and risk management, these are the most important parts of project management. So what is actually a risk? An uncertain event or condition that if occur has a positive or negative effect on one or more project objectives. So anything, any incident, any activity, any accident, whatever happen which can affect positively or negatively in our project is called risk. Risk is not only negative always, it is also positive. So what is project risk management? Project risk management is the process of identifying, analyzing, and then responding to any risk that arises over the life cycle of a project to help the project remain on track and meet its goal. Risk management isn't reactive only. It should be a part of planning process to figure out risks that might happen in the project and how to control that risk. Okay. Risk management is actually not only reaction, your reaction if something is happening. Actually, it is a part of planning. That is called risk management planning. Whenever a project is planned, we see all the risks which are involving in that project. I think in face-to-face lecture, we also talked many times about this risk management, or maybe in some class we did a bit about this topic also. So project risk management is actually planning in advance about upcoming risks. Because if you will do planning, you will face those risks more efficiently, and it will less, there will be less negative of impact on the project. So risk management steps, there are 6 risk management steps, and these steps are given on page number on your 11th chapter, page number 431. So what is planning? We will take one by one. Planning risk management, identifying risk, performing qualitative risk analysis, performing quantitative risk analysis, planning risk responses, and controlling risk. So let's start one by one. First, check what are the outputs of these processes. Output means, for example, the first step is plan risk management. So what will be the output? The output of this planning will be risk management plan. The second step is identify risk. Identify risk means you study about the risk, you know what will be the risk and what will be the positive or negative impact. So you make a register for that is called the risk register. Register means as registers has all the information, so getting all the information. Third process is perform qualitative risk analysis. In this process, documentations are made. In quantitative also, documentations are updated. Plan risk responses, in their outcome will be project management plan updates or project documents update. Because plan risk response means what your or project team response will be if certain risk will come. Then the last point is control risk. How we will control those risks? Because sometimes there are some type of risk which we will study later in this subject, which during the planning we know if that risk will come, we will take this action or this action. But there are some type of risk which we cannot take any action on that moment, but we plan that if this risk happen, then we will think or we will take the most suitable action on that time. So what are these type of risks? This we will study when we will reach to the control risk or other type of such topics. So let's start with the planning risk management. What is planning risk management? All these here I will give you only an overview of all the processes. For detail, you have to read your chapter 11, page 431. There all these details are given. So what is planning risk management? Risk planning is the process of identifying or prioritizing and managing risk. So actually in planning, we have to, first of all, we have to make the list of all the risk that can happen in our project or during the time period of the project. After listing them, then we prioritize them, that which are the risk on which we have to start working earlier than other risk, because some risk need more working on that and some risk need less working. So we have to prioritize them. Thirdly is managing them. Once planning is list is done, prioritizing done, then we start managing. Managing means we start working on those risks. So the first thing is planning. The second thing is identify risk. What is this? Risk identification is the process of determining risk that would potentially prevent the program, enterprise or investment from achieving its objective. It includes documentation and communicating the concern. For example, we identify the risk that okay, maybe the weather is not good, and after 1 month there will be storms, there will be heavy rainfall, or there will be snowfall, or heavy wind storm. So we identify this. Then what we will do this? To prevent this, or to prevent the damages from this, first of all, we will contact the concerned department, like the climate control department, and we will counter check with them that every year, can you give us the graph of last 5 years or 6 years, that what was the weather condition in this specific months? If their graphs are also showing that in specific that month there will be a rainfall or snowfall, or the future prediction also show this, then we have to seriously start working on that and take action on that. That is identifying risk. You should know about the upcoming risk details. So that is identify your risk. Third is perform qualitative risk analysis. Perform qualitative risk analysis is the process of numerically analyzing the effect of identify risk on overall project objectives, The key benefit of this process is that it produces quantitative risk information to support decision making in order to reduce project uncertainty. So after identifying that, we contact to the climate control that please provide us the data or something which we should know the frequency of the risk or the climate. They will give us some data or some numerical process here. So what numerical analysis will we do? I am giving you the climate example, so take that example. From that example, we will perform qualitative risk analysis. How? We will take the data of few years or few months of the past and for the broadcasting for the future also, and we analyze that data, and then we take out the conclusion that whether this risk will affect us or not. So what was identifying this? Identifying this was that we know that rain or snow can affect our process, but how we will know that? We will take the qualitative risk analysis of the data. Next is perform quantitative risk analysis. Quantitative risk analysis tends to be more subjective. It focuses on identify risk to measure both the likelihood of the specific risk event occurring during the project life cycle and the impact it will have on the overall schedule should it hit. So in qualitative, we take the subjective more analysis. We identify risk of the same measurement. Okay, the same type of happening occurs in rain, occurs in another project, and this was the damage and this was the effect on the project cycle. So we take that thing to our project also, that if this can affect another project on this level, it can also affect our project timeline. Plan risk response. The risk response planning involves determining ways to reduce or eliminate any threats to the project and also the opportunities to increase their impact. Responses planning means, because we have a list of risk, so we create the response against them, that if this risk will come, our action will be this. If this risk will come, we will perform such to minimize the damage. The final one will be control risk. Risk monitoring control is the process of keeping track of the identified risk, monitoring residual risk and identifying new risk, ensuring the execution of a risk plan. Okay, controlling risk is same as the quality control. What quality control in we do? We keep tracking the processes that whether all work is going as per the quality measurements. But in risk controls, we will be checking that whatever we did planning about the response we will take against the risk, are we doing that? If we are on the same thing, on the same planning, then there is no worry. But if we are not working on the what we did plan for the facing the risk, then this mean we are out of our planning. So control risk will take care of this, whether we are on the right track or on the wrong track in order to face the risk. So this was the outline for what is risk management and this. But in risk management, we will go through one by one in deep detail of all the topics. So in today's lecture, we will only take one topic, that is planning risk management. Why planning risk management we will take? Because planning risk management is a bit long topic, but in next lecture we will cover two or three, because those are not as lengthy as planning risk management. So we will do this in our second part of the video.